I was delivering drugs from Holland to Finland. So my main job was to putting all the bricks into the car and drive safely to another location. The brick is 1 kilo, usually amphetamine or cocaine. From every delivery, I was making 20,000 euros in cash, only cash. In this game, it's only cash. When you get the money, so what I need is a party, nice hotel, a lot of hookers and drugs. Party till you're gonna crash. I didn't care about consequences. One day, you're gonna get caught. When you get caught, you are in a jail. So the bosses, they know a lot of people. They got eyes everywhere. You're just gonna die in jail. I was a drug smuggler for at least 2.5 years. Started 15 years ago. I met the guy in Amsterdam. He was very, very nice guy. He knows how to talk. We met up. We start talking, smoking weed, laughing. I was curious, did he still need some people, drivers or anything? In 2 days, you can make 20,000 euro. So why not to risk it? The job is simple. Somebody gonna put the bricks into your stash because you cannot do it of the fingerprints and the DNA. You give your car, they take it for a few days. You get a call, you meet up somewhere on the street. They give you the keys, they give you the car, they give you location, and they give you the name who's gonna pick it up. Most of the time it was a Jerry name, and you just bring it. My usual route was from Amsterdam, Germany, Poland, Lithuania, Latvia, Estonia, Finland. Usually in my car, I could fit like 150 bricks in one time. So I remember the first time when I delivered my 150 kilos, cocaine or amphetamine, doesn't matter. I sit back in my car, I drive away like, let's say 2 kilometers. I stop in the parking. I was just crying, you know, because only in that time I understood how risky it is. I was making 7 trips in 1 year. The car with the drug inside is minimum 1 million. Usually the garages, they know which car is the best. If you're gonna drive 200 kilos, so they will say, yeah, buy Mercedes S-Class, because there we know where to make a bigger stash. The stash is made or underneath the back seat or underneath the trunk. So my dog was also playing a role. Because when you open the trunk, there's a dog with his belongings, you know. The dog will hide all the smell from the drugs. Underneath the spare tire, there is a stash. And even to get closer into that, it's not so easy. It was made with the locks. And to activate the locks, you have to turn the fog light, radio, and then you're taking the magnet and you have to put it in the special location to activate and open the stash. From every delivery, I was making 20,000 euros in cash, only cash. When you get the money, I'm still young. So what I need is a party, nice hotel, a lot of hookers and drugs, you know, and just party till you're gonna crash. Nobody knew from my family, from my friends, nobody knew what I was doing. Even if they have some questions, you just deny it, you know. You're not letting them to even to start the conversation about that. The gang, what I was working for, they're gonna push you to the limit. Let's say they would give you, I don't know, 500 grams of weed, and they would ask you to deliver somewhere, yeah? And they would make like a situation that police already is catching you. But the police is not real police. They're just the guys from the gangs, you know, with the dressed up as police. Before the first delivery, when you already have the keys and you have your car, you think already you're gonna just drive, but then the guy asks you where your family lives. It was a story that the guy wasn't careful enough, and he was saying to other people what he's doing, and he just disappeared. Till this day, nobody knows where he is. If more bricks are missing, they're just gonna dig the hole and bury you, and nobody gonna find you. Nothing was making me happy. The drugs was not making me happy. The hookers was not making me happy. I was depressed. I don't want to talk with nobody. It was making me paranoid. I was afraid that police, border patrol is already watching me. I was thinking that they are letting me do this delivery, but they are waiting for the big stash to catch. Douana is specialized police. They are searching for guys like me. They are psychologists for when they stop you, from that moment when your window goes down, the real game starts. They watch into your eyes. You have to look back into his eyes and act very normal. What I was delivering, if I was get caught, I would get like, let's say minimum 15 years in a jail. I was get caught only with weed. When I was get caught with the weed, I was just smiling, you know. The one asked me, why are you smiling? And I answered, yeah, because it's the end for me. I will never go back to Holland because they still know my face. I think we still have some pictures of me. I think more people knows my face. So if they're gonna catch me, I'm just gonna disappear. I think they're just gonna kill me because I don't wanna work for them no more. What I would say to the guy that he want to do this job, I would say, one day you're gonna get caught. When you get caught, you are in a jail. And the bosses, they know a lot of people, yeah? So even in the jail, you get killed. They got eyes everywhere.